Right, we're back now, and it's the 23rd of February. We're back out, and this is what we're going to be looking at now. This is all my new stock, which I've bought for the new breeding season. And we've got the pearly goldies at the top, there are diamorphic hens, and I've also bought a Siberian cock goldie. And just down below him, it's a cock bullfinch Siberian. Now the reason why they're separate like that is because I bought the cock 3 weeks ago and he's in quarantine now. He's been sprayed and he's been fed with the proper foods. I've given bullfinch mix and he has the vitamins in the water, and he's been on that now for the last 3 weeks. He's ready now to be returned to the bird room, which I'll show you in a minute. The cock Siberian, I'm picking the hen up when I go to Stafford when the show's on in a couple of weeks' time. The goldies, I've just brought the hen in this morning. I've had the cock for a couple of weeks, and I bought the hen this morning. Now, all these have been in quarantine. They've all been sprayed properly, and the reason for that is you must buy separate from different breeders when you're pairing, because you don't really know if you're going to be too closely bred. That's why I always buy from separate breeders. And down in my area now, as I'm going to go down, I'm going to show you the situation there. All these shutters have got to come down, and then I've got to sex all these birds in here over the next couple of days. A lot of them will be moved on to different breeders, sold on. And then also clean both ivories out and put the pairs in there when I'm going to use them there. Now coming into my bird room, which is now finished. I'll stand back here. This is as we walk in through the front door. Well, this is inside my bird room, where I shall be spending a lot of time in the next few weeks. Now I've put the nest bowls in this morning just to make sure that the right fittings on the brackets at the back of the cages. But I shall remove all them today and mark them from 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on all the way down. Since the last time I videoed in here, I have done some alterations. These breeding cages were double breeders just butted together, but what I've done, I've cut them all out. If you can see, this is the recess. That was one double breeder, and I've cut them all out all the way through, top and bottom. So it's a complete flight all the way into this flight here. Now this part here, it's where the Siberian bullfinches are going. It's all ready for them to go in there, but I shan't be doing that just yet. The nesting site is just up here in the corner. That's the nesting site up there. But what I shall do, I shall introduce the cock bully at the top here. That trimmer, like you'll have all that trimmer breeding part here. And the hen I shall put in here so you can see her. And I shall leave him for a couple of weeks and then let the hen, the cock, go through to her. And then I shall introduce them. My diamorphics, red factors, little Gloucesters, and whatever else I decide to put in here for breeding. And we should be up and away in the next couple of, well, I would say another 6 weeks before it's completely started. Some people go down early, but I'd prefer to leave it till the middle of April, because then the weather will start to warm up properly. But I have noticed this morning that canaries in the flight area carry material, bits and bobs, leaves and sticks, trying to build already. This is a view from inside the bird room, looking down the garden, and it's absolutely beautiful in the summer. But I shall spend the next week or so now cleaning all out here and doing what you do in the garden, I suppose. I shall jet wash all the block work, clean all my pond out, the aviaries will be all cleaned out, and then I'll just sit back and let nature take its course and enjoy the benefits of breeding some lovely birds, hopefully. I had some great success last year. I bred over 30 dimorphics, 20 red factors, 15-20 bronzes, and I just loved it. Brilliant. But the key to it all is keep your bird room tidy, change your water twice a day, make sure the birds are well fed twice a day, and I can't see what problems you should have. But I must stress here, if you haven't got your birds yet, buy your birds early and put them in separate cages away from the bird room or the aviary, because you don't know what they're carrying. I mean, I had that problem many years back. I bought some birds, I brought them into my bird room, and unfortunately they was carrying red mites and feather mites, and it completely ruined my whole breeding season. I had to fumigate all my bird room. I had to strip it all down, fumigate it, paint it, and with red mites, it's hard to get rid of. It took me ages to do it, and I wouldn't like anybody else to get through what I went through. I lost all my birds. That's going back quite a number of years ago. But as I say, you learn through your mistakes. But as you can see, this is what I'm up to at the moment. And I shall be reducing, bringing some of the birds in either this afternoon or tomorrow. And all my surplus is already sold on. So I hope you've enjoyed this little chat this morning. And I'm going to sign off now, and I will be back shortly, just before the breeding season. So I hope you've enjoyed everything I've said to you. And I'll talk to you a bit more about the feeding the young, the type of the seeds I use, all different types, what I use for my birds, what I mix for myself. And hopefully it might help somebody, some of you lots. So until I speak to you again, I'll see you soon. Bye now. How do I get this up now, just to read it, to hear it? Huh?